where I've gotten has been through word of mouth. And again, that hard name that I put up on the board earlier, that, you know, not everyone can say that name. But guess what? They can say it now, right? I do not chase my business. My business chases me. And that way, I give other people an opportunity to be successful in ways, like we've literally had people tell us, you changed my life. And I mean, I never get tired of hearing that. It humbles me because it also, and also too, don't, and this is one thing I must tell you, stay humble. Don't ever believe your own hype for more than about 5 minutes, okay? Seriously, because I've seen people just think, oh, I'm everything there to be. Guess what? Someone's going to replace you. Everyone is replaceable. But here's the thing. You're not in it to hype yourself up. You're in this because you have a passion. You have a desire to help people. Anybody that's in business to just make money will fail. They always, yeah. Right? Mm-hmm. And I don't wish that on them. They did that to themselves, right? But if you genuinely help people and you're out there to do the best thing that you can do, don't undervalue yourself. Don't undercharge. Don't be the cheapest, you know, but volunteer. Understand the value of what that brings to the table. That will give you experience, right? But then, most importantly, don't fall into your own hype. When people tell me things like, you changed my life, that humbles me. It makes me grateful that I was in their path and I could be with them on this journey. But guess what? I think about it for about 2 minutes and I'm like, well, now I have to do even better. Because if I change your life, uh-oh, this means I have to raise the bar and help somebody else, right? And it keeps me on my A game. Because that's what I wake up to every morning, and I know you do too. What's going to make me better and be a better service today, right? And as Maria said, we are people of faith. You know, we may have different faiths, right? But at the end of the day, the reason that we're here is to add value to someone else's life, career, to our communities, right? How else are we going to do that if we're buying our own hype too much? So you can be awesome, but you don't need to, if you're stuck in thinking you're awesome, because people fall into that trap all the time, guess what's going to happen? The same thing about when you're stuck, when you're scared. You're not going to move forward. You will not innovate. Everything I do scares the heck out of me. But I still do it. Because guess what? If I don't do it, what's going to happen? Regret. Regret is the enemy of innovation. Right? I may have something that somebody might need. And because I was frightened, I never did it. So get your training, but be the model. Be the leader, because a leader is not somebody that stands in the front and tells you what to do. That can be a supervisor. That's not a leader. A leader is someone who's behind you, pushing you forward. It's somebody that's next to you and grabbing the hand of the person behind them. That's how you lead, from the middle, from the back, never from the front. Okay? And that's a lot that I never see out there. I don't see it out there too much, I should say. So lead from the middle. Be in the crowd that you're in. So everything you're going through, guess who's been through it before you already? And guess what? We didn't have this. We didn't have women doing it afraid, did we? No, we did not. So I want you guys to think about that. Because right where you are right now, there's someone else that's standing behind you. That's waiting for you to be successful. That's waiting for you to listen to what we're telling you. Right? So you can help them up too. So get trained. Always get training. I will never stop training. It's a journey that never ends, right? 10 years later, she wants to get her cosmetology license. I can tell you, she does excellent makeup. You don't want to see the things in her shop. And when I walk into her shop, I'm like, yep, I'm going to look so much better when I leave this place, right? But just like with training, when people come to me, I know that I will change whatever you were doing before. How do I know that? Not because I'm buying my own Kool-Aid, but because I was in that seat. I know what it takes to get out of that seat. I know what it takes to get not only in the back, the middle, but I do know what it takes to get into the front. And once I'm at the front of one line, what do? I jump in the middle or the back of another line. That's what you have to keep doing. So leading is a curve.
It's a continuous journey.
It is. And I should say leader, in addition to being a noun, leader is a verb. Just like for those of you who are parents, right? Being a parent is not a noun. It is a verb. You do it every day, right? And then, and for those of you that have spouses, spousing is a verb. It's some days way easier than dating, right? So when you lead, it's not who you are, it's what you do. It's an action word. So I want you to always keep that in your frame of reference.